topic is about meat inspection, but it is divided into two topics. One is ante-mortem inspection, another is post-mortem inspection. Earlier we have already discussed in details about the slaughter and dressing of meat animals and different details including the human slaughter and ritual slaughter. Actually the meat inspection, particularly the ante-mortem inspection, should be discussed before the slaughter, but I wanted to bring this topic under one. So the meat inspection, it will be covered in two topics. First one is ante-mortem inspection of food animals. Meat inspection is very important to provide safe and wholesome meat for human consumption. A proper meat inspection consists of a veterinary examination of the live animal or bird and examination of carcass and offal after slaughter. A proper ante-mortem examination represents at least 50% of meat inspection, making post-mortem examination more efficient and easy. In the diagram bottom, it is showing the flow of meat availability, that is from farm to fork, as we say, that is the starting from the animal in the farm. So there should be inspection, then during loading, on the way of transportation, during unloading, and just before slaughter, and then final post-mortem examination after the slaughter for the carcass and the offals. The responsibility of meat inspection lies primarily with veterinarians and qualified meat inspectors who are specifically trained for this job. They are the actual representatives of public health authorities at the abattoirs for assuring the quality of meat for human consumption. Meat inspection broadly comprises of ante-mortem, that is before death, and post-mortem, that is after death examination. So there is two kind of examination of the meat animals. One is before slaughter. It could be even long before, during the journey or transport or in the farm, as I said earlier, and the examination after slaughter, that is called post-mortem examination. Here I will speak little more details about ante-mortem inspection. Ante-mortem examination refers to the examination of live animals or birds prior to slaughter, as I already told. The purpose of ante-mortem inspection is to ensure that only clean, healthy, and stress-free animals are presented for slaughter. It is the first step of meat inspection and has significant role in the production of wholesome meat. So wholesome meat means the healthy meat, disease-free meat. So to assure the quality supply of meat, the animals must be examined or inspected by the qualified veterinarian so that any diseased animals can be eliminated. Then only we can assure the quality of meat. So this plays a very important role for the safeguard of human health. Little more to explain about ante-mortem inspection. The inspection panes in the layerage should be sufficiently large with ample natural and artificial light for proper inspection and to detect abnormalities. All animals should be inspected at different stages, that is on the farm, during transportation, during unloading, in the layerage, and on the day of slaughter or just before slaughter. If slaughter delayed, the procedure of ante-mortem inspection should be repeated. So this is a brief idea about the ante-mortem inspection. Then we will go further details about the topic in the next slide. The ante-mortem inspection, now we will call it in short AMI. This topic we are going to discuss in four important subheadings. One is objective, where I will explain more details about the purpose and importance. Then second, the requirements, that is what are the necessary things for the proper antemortem inspection. Third is the procedure, that is in details how to conduct the antemortem inspection, what are the things to be recorded and what observations should be made. And the fourth is the judgment, that is the decision. After the inspection, what decision is taken based on the observation. So these are the four subheading under which we are going to discuss this whole topic in little details. Objectives of antemortem inspection. Number one, detection of animals suffering from infectious diseases. So all such animals should be removed and prevented to go for slaughter. Number two, detection of contagious diseases that are difficult to diagnose at PMI. So many diseases will have clear symptom at the living stage, but after slaughter it will be difficult to find such symptoms or signs. That is easy to identify during antemortem inspection. Number three, prevention of food poisoning outbreaks. By eliminating many conditions or diseases, we can eliminate the possibility of food poisoning or which are carried through these animals and meat. Facilitation of more efficient, accurate and less laborious PMI, that is postmortem inspection. So this proper antemortem inspection makes the postmortem inspection easy, or sometimes it gives proper indication for some animals which need to be inspected better during postmortem. Number five, protection of health of workers. So the workers who are working at different section of the abattoir are always vulnerable and susceptible to many disease. So by eliminating many disease conditions of the animals, we can save the remaining of the workers to get exposed. Then number six, prevention of contamination of the abattoir. So by chance, if any diseased animal goes and gets slaughtered, that causes contamination of the abattoir or floor or machineries, including the workers. So that's a big hazard which can be avoided if we eliminate such animals at the beginning. Implementation of disease control program. This is a very important. So in developed countries, most of the disease outbreak is detected from the abattoir. So when they are properly inspected or sometime checked, they can identify many contagious disease and they can send the proper notification to the origin of the animals, and that is how the disease control programs are implemented. And finally, number eight, prevent inhuman handling of animals. This is one of the requirement for animal welfare rules to be implemented. So that can be checked here by inspection. If there is injuries, beating, improper handling, that can be checked and implemented accordingly. Importance of antemortem inspection. To ensure the selection of normal and well-rested animals and poultry, which lead to production of high quality meat. So antemortem inspection plays important role for producing the wholesome meat. To ensure protection of consumers from the zoonotic and other diseases through consumption of infected meat. So meat is a very, very common source for many diseases. So the antemortem inspection plays very important role as part of meat inspection program to safeguard the human health from such diseases. Separation of animals with diseases like rabies, tetanus. Some of the diseases are very, very fatal. So such diseases, particularly rabies, tetanus, they have got clear symptoms only before slaughter. So they can be eliminated through antemortem inspection. Then to reduce contamination of the killing floor, equipment and personnel from communicable diseases. This I have already explained previously. So if we eliminate the diseased animal, we can make the slaughter operation from getting broke down. We can prevent such hazards. Importance of AMI, prevention of food poisoning outbreaks. So as I said, the meat is a best medium and it is common source of many food poisoning organisms, or sometimes they grow later on in the meat. So proper inspection can eliminate the presence of such food poisoning organisms like salmonellosis or many such listeriosis, many such zoonotic disease. So we can avoid the foodborne diseases or food poisoning outbreaks which comes from the meat if we properly follow the meat inspection procedures. In this case, it starts with the antemortem inspection. To assist in establishing and promoting a great export trade by ensuring that all meat exported shall be clean and wholesome. So if we have to improve our meat trade, we need to improve the hygienic practices and quality of meat, and we need to improve our meat industry, for which meat inspection plays a very important role. So therefore, the antemortem inspection is the most important part for implementing such meat inspection program and to improve the meat export. To enforce the application of human methods of handling and slaughter of meat animals. So this is an important requirement, that is animal welfare. All the developed countries, if they want to import our meat, they need to be assured that the proper animal welfare is taken care of. So that can be implemented by proper antemortem inspection to rule out the inhuman handling. To ensure collection of reliable clinical information which make postmortem decisions easy. So this is a support for postmortem inspection. In case of any doubts, we need to give proper mark or remark and notes, or sometimes we need to collect proper samples for doubtful animals so that it can be further checked and matched during postmortem inspection. Now we are at the second part of this topic, that is requirements for antemortem inspection. Adequate restraint of animals, that is the major requirement. So restraining materials like ropes, trebis, etc. should be available. Satisfactory identification facilities for animals, that is by using metal, plastic or nylon ear tags, neck and leg bands, ear tattoos, collars or paints, etc. Properly designed and well-lit layerage pens or isolation pen. Sometimes the sick animal will be in isolation pen. There also they need to be checked or inspected. Then crust for the examination of individual animals. And assistance by competent supporting staff. Sufficient number of supporting staff is required to assist the veterinary doctors for conducting the antemortem inspection or documenting all other informations, etc. In continuation, conditions for antemortem inspection. It should be ensured that animals are not subjected to any kind of cruelty. That is, in the process of antemortem inspection, animals should be handled properly, gently, and there should not be any cruelty. A number of para-veterinary staff should be at hand to help in the examination or to check the animals. All animals meant for slaughter should be rested well. At least 12 hours before slaughter, no feed should be given and plenty of water should be provided in the layerage. Schedule of antemortem inspection, that is the timing when it should be done. The antemortem inspection has to be conducted on the day of arrival of animals at abattoir. That is, if the animals are transported, when they are unloaded, there should be a preliminary examination. Then AMI should be conducted 12 to 24 hours before slaughter by qualified veterinarians in the layerage. So layerage is the place, I have been telling it earlier. The inspection is repeated immediately before slaughter if the animal has been held for more than 12 hours. When the animal is inspected but in waiting for slaughter for more than 24 hours, then there should be again an inspection. The inspection must be repeated if required by the veterinarian. If condition of the animal does not allow a definitive assessment of its health. So sometime it is difficult to make a decision, the symptoms are not clear and there are doubts. In that case, re-inspection is required. Now we are at the third part, that is the procedure of antemortem inspection. Livestock in the layerage should be inspected at rest and while in motion. Both sides of the animal should be observed. That is the when the animal is in standing or resting and when the animal is moving, both the conditions and both sides we have to check it. In practice, this is simple to carry out while the animals are being unloaded, but their excited state during this procedure may mask some conditions like lameness. So when the animals are unloaded at that time, it is easy to observe most of the symptoms, but some of the symptoms cannot be observed because animal will be excited to run. At that time, some lameness like things may be failed to observe. Look for sick or suspect diseased animals and those in poor condition. So we have to look for any disease symptoms or any other poor condition, which we are going to discuss further later. Here we will quickly see some of the important signs of health and welfare, which is commonly known by veterinary doctors, like see the sunken eyes, purulent discharge from the nose or saliva, droopy cold ears, which is the sign of fever, then neck bump, arched back, it is a standing change due to certain abnormality and pain inside, or backbone bumps, sometime is an indication, empty rumen, so that shows there is total lack of feeding, sometime there is uplifted tail, that indicates some kind of pain in the birth canal, or manure on pelvis, the sign of diarrhea, sometime pus on tail, wound on flank, or sometime broken ribs, or sometime the dirty odor, shoulder bump, or many strongly visible bones indicating the overall condition or emaciation. And also we need to know the location of some of the superficial lymph nodes, especially the prescapular lymph nodes, which need to be checked often, and some of the lymph nodes at the head region like submaxillary or submandibular lymph nodes. So this is some of the things which is known by the veterinary doctors which should be used for antemortem inspection. So in continuation of procedure for antemortem inspection, we should observe the general health, appearance, and any indications of abnormality, even response to stimuli, whether they are fatigued, and look for any signs of inhuman handling, which I told earlier, whether there is any injury, subcutaneous injuries or other things, broken legs or other horn injury, etc., to ascertain the animal welfare aspect and cruelty. The animals showing abnormal conditions are to be segregated. Check superficial lymph nodes, temperature, respiration, pulse. If there is any signs of abnormality, we have to separate them and check for all this thing. In case of female, look for mastitis, metritis, or retained placenta. Normally, the immediately recent parturition, such cows should not be slaughtered or not permitted. If unacceptably dirty, that cannot be dressed at normal line speed. So we have to check if some animals are extremely dirty, that cannot be permitted for slaughter. Procedure for antemortem inspection in continue. The calves are mainly observed for their maturity, because the immature calves are not permitted for slaughter many times. Calves unable to stand up, lack of normal growth, have infected navels, and joint enlargements are to be separated and examined individually. These are very common illness, joint ill or navel infection. The records of antemortem inspection are mandatory and should include date and time of inspection, truck number, the total number of animals, and the name of the owner. We also need to record the species, class, age, condition, color, or markings, and identification number are to be recorded. Parameters to be recorded, or I can say some of the clinical parameters need to be recorded to check the normal conditions. So conditions that are recorded during antemortem examination are abnormalities of temperature, pulse, respiration rates, behavior, posture, gait, structure, discharge, and protrusion. So first one is the temperature. If the temperature is high, there is possibility of some kind of septicemia or infection, which need to be checked thoroughly with more details if there is a specific infection, and accordingly the decision has to be taken once we understand the what kind of disease. Here is the normal temperature, pulse and respiration rate of three important species. Just for a quick recapitulation, every veterinarians are supposed to know this. That is, in case of sheep and goat, first is temperature 39.5 degrees Celsius, in pigs 39 degrees Celsius, and in cattle and buffaloes 39 degrees Celsius. These are the normal values. In case of pulse per minute, sheep and goat 75, pigs 75, cattle and buffaloes 50. Then respiration per minute, sheep and goat 12 to 20, pigs 10 to 16, and cattle and buffaloes 12 to 16. So this is for quick recapitulation, which should be in mind while doing the such kind of checking. We need to also record the pulse rate and respiration. As I told, these are very common observations for the practicing veterinarian. The pulse rate in a healthy animal, the pulse rate is fairly constant, as the number I have already told, and often faster in young animals. Check the pulse in coccygeal artery in case animal is showing any abnormality. Whenever we are seeing any kind of abnormality or signs of temperature, we can check the pulse rate. Similarly, the respiration. To measure the respiratory rate, observation should be made at the flank region of the animal. If the breathing pattern looks abnormal, the animal should be segregated as suspect. So whenever there is temperature, the pulse rate also may be higher, and there may be higher rate of respiration, then such animals should be checked for any specific disease or other symptoms. We are discussing about different parameters to be recorded. One important is the behavior or general behavior, manifested variously like reeling, dull and anxious expression in the eyes, and aggressiveness. So if there is any kind of abnormality, the behavior also will change, or the general response to the stimuli will change. So an experienced eye of a veterinarian can easily catch such kind of behavioral changes. Then about posture. Observe when the animal is in standing or lying positions. Cow sits on the flank and head rests on the flank. That's a typical posture that can happen due to milk fever. So posture indicates how an animal is standing or lying in a normal way, normal condition. So if there is any kind of abnormalities, this normal posture will change. Frog-like posture, that can happen in obturator paralysis and bilateral dysplasia. Kicking at the belly, this kind of symptom may be seen when there is acute pain inside. In continuation, as I said, posture, that is the way animal stands or sits, whereas gait, it is the way animal walks, how it moves. So it has a normal pattern. When there is a deviation, that is abnormal. Generally observed when the animal moves, walks, and helps to detect conditions like pain in the legs, chest and abdomen. So when there is a slow oval gait, that indicates septicemia diseases. When it is walking in circles, particularly in sheep and goat, that indicates coniurosis or listeriosis. When there is stiff gait, that indicates traumatic pericarditis. These are some of the common conditions where there is a change of gait or how the animal moves. Discharges and protrusions. Discharges from nose, mouth, bloody diarrhea, and protrusions like prolapsed uterus and prolapsed rectum are indicative of bodily abnormalities. So some different kind of discharge indicates the signs of abnormality, which are easily identified for certain kind of disease. We have to see the signs of physical exhaustion, usually manifested by dehydration, reflected as loss of skin elasticity, sunken eyeballs, dry mucous membrane, fatigue, weakness, stiffness and pain. So this could happen due to long journey or not proper feeding or not proper water is given. Other abnormal conditions most frequently observed at antemortem inspection is injuries that could be natural or due to fighting or due to improper vehicle or improper care or improper handling or panic. There could be due to heat symptoms, apoplexy, transient tetany and lesions of foot and mouth disease and rabies. So these are some of the common other symptoms to be observed. Diseases to be looked for during antemortem inspection. Here is the some of the common disease in different species which are commonly found or should be checked during antemortem inspection. The symptoms of all these diseases should be well known to a veterinary doctor. I will just tell the name of the diseases for different species which must be checked carefully. In case of cattle, it is rabies, tetanus, anthrax, blackwater, FMD, TB, pneumonia. In case of calves, immaturity, emaciation, cough diphtheria, white scours, cowpox, arthritis. In case of sheep and goat, emaciation, sheep pox, FMD, pneumonia, caseous lymphadenitis. In case of swine or pigs, swine fever, rabies, pseudorabies, swine erysipelas, TB, FMD, lameness, swine vesicular disease, atropic rhinitis. In case of poultry, few common diseases like Marek's disease, Ranikhet, chronic respiratory disease, fowl cholera, salmonellosis, ascites, infectious bursal disease. So these diseases should be checked during antemortem inspection in different species. Now we are at the fourth and last part of this lecture, that is the judgments or decisions. So based on the examination, we have to make the judgments. Basically, we can classify into six category, that is the fit, unfit, suspect, detained, casualty and emergency category. All of them I'm going to explain very briefly. So here I will explain all the different category. Number one is the fit, that is animals judged healthy and are passed for slaughter. So when there is no signs of any disease, no other objectionable conditions, they are passed for slaughter and such animal will produce the acceptable meat. Number two, unfit. Animals should not enter the plant. They are totally rejected for slaughter. That could be dead, moribund, or emaciated, or excessively dirty, or animals with septicemia, that is different kind of infectious disease. Some of the most common which should be unfit are rabies, FMD, hemorrhagic septicemia, anthrax, blackwater. These are all unfit for slaughter. Then number three, suspect. So this is the category of animals where we cannot decide. The decision should be done after the slaughter. So there should be symptoms of antemortem, postmortem, and some other laboratory result. All together it has to be decided. So animals that are sent for slaughter must be accompanied by a full veterinary report, antemortem signs, postmortem findings, and the results of laboratory test for final judgment. Number four category, that is delayed slaughter. So here there is not much problem with the any kind of disease, but they need rest, so it has to be delayed. The fatigued, excited and inadequately rested, and animals affected with transient sickness. These animals require rest, maybe proper feed and water, or sometimes some treatment. Then they will regain the normal condition and they can be slaughtered later. So such animals should be kept in the holding pen. The examples are like excessively fatigued and excited animals. Number five, casualty slaughter. Here the casualty slaughter refers to the situation where an animal is not in acute pain and in no immediate danger of death, but affected with a chronic condition. So here the animal is not healthy, it has got certain problem, but it is not a serious issue, neither threatening to life. So such conditions we call it casualty slaughter. It can be done any time casually. So examples are like obturator paralysis. So such animal cannot be recovered, it cannot be normal walking, etc. Sometime postpartum paraplegia, the hindquarter get paralyzed, such animal cannot be recovered. So following the milk fever, so these conditions will go for casualty slaughter. Number 6 is emergency slaughter. So emergency slaughter is required when an animal is in acute pain or is suffering from a condition where a delay in slaughter would be contrary to the philosophy of animal welfare. That is, when the animal is facing a great danger of death, but as such there is not much risk to any public health hazard. But if we don't slaughter it quickly, it may die, then we may get an economic loss. So just for the salvage of the meat, it can be slaughtered quickly. So for which I have told while talking about the design of slaughterhouse, there is a separate unit for emergency slaughter, or it is called a miniature abattoir. The examples are like severe fracture of limbs, especially in large animals, which is very difficult to be cured. Severe lacerations and bruises, or maybe due to severe severe accident, damage to pelvis, animals struck by lightning, though it is alive, acute respiratory or other penetrating wounds of the thorax or abdomen. So all these conditions are very difficult to recover and animal's life is in threat. Such animals can be slaughtered under emergency slaughter category. Slaughter under special condition. So animals showing evidence of localized conditions such as minor injuries, abscesses, benign tumors need to be segregated and need a detailed examination. Some undergo regular kill if the condition proves to be minor. Some slaughtered at the end of day's kill or slaughtered separately and subjected to thorough postmortem examination. So now we are almost at the end. A few special instructions: where the postmortem inspection is necessary for diagnosis, the official veterinarian shall request to slaughter separately or at the end of normal slaughtering. So sometime, as I said, this antemortem inspection plays a role in the disease control program. So sometimes some disease need to be diagnosed. That time it should be done carefully so that proper sample collection can be done. Then animals which may contain residues of pharmaceutical product must be detained for post-mortem testing. In this case also, proper samples should be collected from specific tissues. So there, during the antemortem inspection, proper notes or remarks should be given so that the samples can be collected during post-mortem inspection. Then for public health purposes, the veterinarians must separate normal animals from those which may be suffering from a zoonotic disease. Now we are at the end of today's lecture. I will just summarize. So first I discuss briefly about meat inspection and its role. It has got two part, antemortem inspection and postmortem inspection. Today I have discussed in this topic only about antemortem inspection. Here at the beginning I have explained what is antemortem inspection and its importance, the objectives of antemortem inspection and some of the other details about it, and then about the requirements and facilities and schedules I have discussed, and then I have discussed details procedure and some of the important recording parameters, what should be taken care of. And finally, about the decisions or judgments, different category depending on the conditions, and some of the common diseases which should be identified during antemortem inspection. So please, further you can study from the lecture notes. Hope it is useful. Thank you.